Hello everyone, and welcome back to the lab. In the last video, I experimented with a fluorescent tube filled with low pressure air. This time, we'll try to make a neon tube. To do so, however, I need to come up with some kind of vacuum manifold, as I need to first connect the would-be neon tube to the vacuum pump, and then to the neon cylinder. The most basic manifold I can think of starts from a connection to the vacuum pump. Then, we need a valve, and after the valve, a connection to the neon cylinder that already has its own valve, then a port for the vacuometer, and finally the connection to the neon tube. I can make all of the glass parts except for the valve that I bought. I bought it as new old stock, as I couldn't find a soda lime valve. Apparently all modern scientific glassware is borosilicate, which is harder for me to work with. Making this apparatus took way too many attempts, as my T-joints kept breaking off, and I had to learn how to make them somewhat reliable, so let's just show the finished result. As I still don't have a vacuometer, the vacuometer port is stoppered, and I'll have to eyeball how much neon gas to add, but I think it's okay for a first experiment. Let's get started then. First, we start by turning on the vacuum pump. Then, we open the vacuum valve. My vacuum pump is a two-stage mechanical pump and can't really bring the pressure low enough. As a result, enough air remains in the tube to make it glow, even before we add neon. The next step is heating the neon tube with hot air to attempt to displace water vapor and other impurities from the inner surface of the glass. After this is done, the vacuum valve is closed and the neon cylinder valve is carefully opened. This is a metering valve designed to only let a tiny amount of gas flow. Without a vacuometer, it's really hard to get the right neon pressure, but when I felt it was good enough, I skipped to the next step, sealing the glass tube. I use my thermal camera to monitor the glass temperature and know when it's safe to touch. The vacuum pump can be stopped, and I turned on the lights to avoid overexposing the camera. When the lamp is turned on, the electrodes do glow with the neon color, but the gas in the tube is dim due to the presence of air in the tube. However, I accounted for that by adding a small piece of magnesium turnings in the tube. By shaking it so that it becomes one of the electrodes, it will sputter a thin layer of reactive magnesium that will attack the remaining air, converting it to solid magnesium oxide and nitride. This way, the partial pressure of air will reduce, leaving only the unreactive neon gas after a few hours of operation. I learned this trick from Akadei. I'll leave a link in the description.
Thank you.
This is the final result. The electrodes need to be improved, as too much sputtering occurs after only a few hours, but the neon glow is clearly visible.